More people are going to the doctor, but not necessarily because they're sick. Instead, they're taking part in medical research studies, and they're getting paid for it. For example, a bone density study for NASA pays $300. And the trend is happening here. Local companies are seeing that boost in clinical research volunteers as well.
In a tough job market, it's one way to make money or at least be able to see a doctor. Lindsay Shively is here to explain. Lindsay, any little bit helps for some people, right?
Certainly, Curtis. From lost jobs to lost health insurance, for more and more people, clinical research is really becoming a viable option, if not their only option. Now, Ramey Schultz has been out of work and will use the cash he gets from a clinical trial to start his own business. He'll get $5,000 to stay 19 days and nights at this clinic in Overland Park while doctors use his body to research the effects of a new possible drug to treat Alzheimer's. Ramey is glad that he'll not only get the money to help start his business, but also plenty of time to work on it as well. They have a lot of free time. Now, there's another group of volunteers emerging too. Unemployed people who no longer can afford but need medical care seek it out through these trials too, especially trials about an illness they might have, like someone suffering from asthma may take part in a trial for an asthma drug, or someone suffering cancer participates in cancer drug research, simply because they will get to see doctors for treatment.
We've definitely seen an increase in people wanting to participate in clinical trials because of additional income, because of a spouse that might have lost a job or themselves. Our job is to put safety first and make sure that that person is stable and appropriate for a clinical trial, not just because they want to do it for the money.
Very important. And as always, with any kind of medical research, there is risk, but that's the whole point. Drug companies aren't sure what these drugs will be doing. But Dr. Vince points out almost all the drugs we have on the market today had to go through trials first, or we might not have them. Lindsay Shively, NBC Action News Today.